Prince Oaks?
P.O. Positive or Pet P?
I wonder what it'll be today. Actually, no. Nancy, the floor is yours.
Yeah, Jack, I've got a pet peeve. Why do people start fake coughing when I'm smoking in my store? If you don't like it, just leave.
Thank you much, Nancy. And, well, if you're asking, it's not like people have other places to go besides the smokehouse that you call a general store. On to the weather forecast. Sunny in the first half of the day and some clouds in the second.
Driving along the highway, ba-ba-ba-da-da-da.
Hello? Friday Delivery Day.
Well, just call me Friday Delivery K. Okay, no, that sounded better in my head.
Someone's in a good mood today.
Yes, thanks for looking after Max and Gracie last night. You were a real trooper for stepping in last minute.
No problem. They were great.
I appreciate the lie.
So, how was the concert?
Oh, yeah. Man, Journey is so good. Those songs have been stuck in my head all day.
That sounds great.
I know, right? There's just so much cool stuff being created right now, you know? I mean, Journey was cool. I got to know them through Barry at first, but I tell you, if Prince or New Order ever came to Portland, I would sell my spleen for tickets.
One spleen, two bands. That's quite the potential dilemma.
Oh, and I haven't even mentioned Cyndi Lauper, or Run DMC, or Stevie Wonder. And before you go there, I know you're probably setting up a joke about spleens and Hammond organs right now.
Oh, I would never.
All jokes aside, though, I spent half the concert thinking about how I haven't really focused on my own music for a while now. Kids, work, all that stuff. So much going on. And I mean, I love tinkering, but right now, I'm not sure I'm even creating anything cool or just You know, not even Barry is allowed to listen to my songs at this stage, to be honest.
You never know until you put yourself out there.
I guess that's true. I was thinking, I have a mixtape with some of my stuff, you know? Just something I've been trying out with my new synthesizer.
I'd be honored.
That's great! It's just something I've been playing around with. Don't expect any fireworks. And hey, don't tell me what you think yet, yeah? You'll be my secret special audience of one, so I can get used to the idea of an audience.
Any special reason?
Okay, don't tell anyone, but I'm thinking of performing a song on my new synth this Sunday. Holy crap, I just said that out loud! Dude! You are coming to the open mic, right?
Of course! That's great! Wild horses couldn't drag me away.
But act cool, yeah? No one else knows yet. See you there.
Sure thing! Back to my own journey, for now. Haha!
Nope, ignoring that. Bye now!
Ah, the waxworms have arrived.
Excuse me?
I meant the package, Miss Weiss. It's my worms. For fishing. They're just in time. I'm taking a boat to the island this afternoon.
Great. Have fun.
Hey, you can tag along if you want, like your father used to. But I'm not helping you with any wax worms.
Oh, really? Sounds like fun.
Okay, we'll show up here at 4 p.m. sharp.
These look like bills.
Meredith!
Hey, Robert.
How are you? I was away for a few days, on an urgent job out of state.
I'm good. It's nice to see you again. Here's the mail.
Thanks, and likewise. Priority mail from Town Hall. Let's see what they have to say this time. Dear Mr. Harris, on behalf of yada yada yada... Concerning Environmental Management Act 1213, yada yada yada. Wait. What? Listen to this. We have decided to postpone the construction of apartments for at least 6 months. We hope this satisfies you as well as the many residents of Providence Oaks that contacted us with their unfiltered and enthusiastic comments. It worked! The plan worked!
Wow, great! So happy for you, Robert.
We need to celebrate this. How about tomorrow night? Steak dinner at Moe's. Or something else. On me.
Sure, yeah.
Great. It's gonna be fun. See you tomorrow night, then. Gotta go now. The telephone troops need to know the assault can be abandoned.
I'm calling it a day. So, is this a quiet day, or does it always take this long?
Fishing requires patience. We've only been here for 2 hours.
And that's the nice thing about fishing.
Well, there's a fine line between boredom and relaxation.
I find it hard to relax sometimes.
Fishing also requires silence.
Bert, can I ask you a question? Do you like Maureen?
We ought to be heading back home. It's been a fine day, and I thank you for the company.
Kay's tape. Let's have a listen. Hello?
Hi, Meredith. Guess what I signed today?
Let me think. The monster deal?
Oh, yes. You are now talking to Steve Mitchell, CEO of a multi-million dollar enterprise. But before I continue my insufferable bragging, I have a thing or two to say to you about you. You've been a huge part of the success of this company, and I feel this is just the beginning. We're entering the golden age of personal computers, and we've got front row tickets. The past 2 weeks have made me realize that I couldn't have done it without you, and I'm going to need you even more in the coming years. So, here's a new monster deal I want you to think about. Become a partner in the company for 20% of the shares and a significant pay raise. Significant. The only condition is that I need your commitment for the next 5 years. So, there it is. Think about it, and let's talk about it more when you're back in the office.
This is a bit of a surprise.
Just let it sink in a bit. I don't need an answer right now. I have to get back to my million-dollar lifestyle. Actually, no, I need to get cranking on lots of stuff. Talk soon, Meredith.
Good evening, feline friends. Aunt Meredith's gonna keep you company tonight.
Come here.
Kitty. Ow. A postcard from Angie.
Miss Meredith, I am so, so sorry I haven't been able to see you. It's just that I've been swamped organizing my not-so-timely exit from Providence Oaks. I'm sure you understand. You've probably seen the foreclosure notice. That certainly helped expedite my decision to leave. Anyway, I'll be honest. I'm still thinking about that kiss we shared in the car. And I don't usually dwell on these kind of things. So, feel special, Meredith. I hear you're going to the open mic night on Sunday. I wasn't planning on going, but I want to see you before I leave. I'm really anxious to find out what you've decided to do. Whether you're going to stay in this town, or go back to the city, or do something else entirely. And I'm going to be forward, as you know I always am. I'd like to know if little old me figures into those plans somehow. So, anyway, I'll see you there, yeah? Love, Angie.
Happy Saturday, everyone. It's time once again for a...
Theo, positive or that key.
Today's verdict is from Cheryl.
Hi, Jack. I went for a walk the other day and suddenly encountered a majestic stag. We looked at each other for a few seconds and then he walked off into the woods.
Wow, Cheryl. I'm glad you could retell the tale. Stags can be dangerous. Today's weather might be dangerous, too.
I didn't bring the package. What on earth do these folks order?
I managed to get the machine to work. Here are the pictures.
Thank you. I'm happy with how they turned out.
If you'd have picked them up earlier this week, you could have participated in a photography contest.
Well, I don't think I would have won anyway.
You can probably only win contests like those if you're a professional.
I'd like to think that talented casual photographers also have a decent chance.
Well, one can always dream.
Answer. These look like bills. Heavier than I thought. It's the mail.
I'm busy.
Okay. Good luck.
No! Damn it! I almost had it. I almost fucking had it. Thanks for breaking my concentration.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Video games are supposed to be fun. I feel horrible. Absolutely horrible.
I know the feeling.
You know what? I can beat this damn game, and I'm not quitting until I have.
Good luck with that.
Okay, fellow Providence Oakians, it's time once again for the Send In Letters and Announcements. This one's from our very own Maureen, or Mo, as we all know.
Hey, Fo. Just wanted to grab your ears for a second to let you know all about the upcoming open mic night over at Mo's Diner this Sunday. That's right. Claim your 15 minutes of fame, enjoy some swell performances, and the usual good food and drinks for everyone. I expect to see all of y'all for a great evening. Maybe even some dancing. You know who you are. Come join the show at Moe's at 8 p.m. this Sunday. I'll come get you if you don't.
Well, you heard her, folks. And I'll be there, too, so you better not miss it. Back to the music and to one of my favorite songs. Mail Carrier Meredith.
Farmer DJ Jack.
Seen any ghost drivers on the way here?
Nope.
Are you sure?
Yes, why?
Okay, I was just wondering. Don't bother. I need to get back to the live show. See you tomorrow, I reckon. Bye now.
I reckon.
Oh, and please close the door. Don't want to broadcast any mail truck noise. Thank you much.
And so ends a week full of turmoil.
I didn't say that again.
Only the Angels hadn't lost to the White Sox. That would have made it perfect.
How much would you have won?
$876.34. It'd have been a nice payday, huh? Playing each other again tonight. Should I change the bet?
Yeah, that sounds logical.
Okay, let's see what happens. Maybe you're my lucky charm. Have a great weekend, Meredith. Oh, wait. This was your last day. I totally forgot to tell you, but they still haven't found someone else for the job. So, I guess, you can have it, if you want.
Wow. That sounds quite nice, actually.
Of course. And it's a great job. You know what? Think about it, and let me know Monday morning when you return your stuff. Gotta run now. Red Sox are playing the Yankees.
Hello?
Hi, Meredith. It's your dad again. How was your time in the mail delivery business?
Oh, hi, Dad. Well, I actually really loved it.
Awesome. Maybe you should just keep doing it. Worked out well for me.
Actually, it seems like they haven't filled the vacancy yet.
They haven't? Well, you know what I'd do. Oh, hold on, Meredith.
Let me guess. Mom wants to talk to me?
Hi, Meredith. Sorry to butt in, but you're thinking about staying in Providence Oak?
Hi, Mom. Well, yeah, why not? I like it here.
Well, PO is wonderful, of course. I know. But you've got so much going on. Do you want to leave all that behind?
Yeah, I guess that's what it comes down to.
Is it just work-related, or are there other people involved? You know, any interesting ones, perhaps?
Well, there are some interesting developments, yes.
Oh, there are? But are they really interesting enough to give up your entire career? I really think you need to think long and hard on it. Oh, hold on.
I have a suspicion Dad wants to talk to me.
Meredith, I just wanted to say, you need to clean the lint filter on the dryer every once in a while. If you never do that, it could burn the house down.
No problem, Dad. I'll make sure to do that.
Great, thanks. I sometimes suddenly worry about things like that in the middle of the night. And it's not about the dryer, of course. I want you to be safe. And I'm sure you'll be okay.
I'll be fine. Don't lose sleep over me.
Okay, Em. Take care. I gotta go. We're running out of coins again. Bye!
I hope you don't think I'm a cheapskate for having dinner here. There aren't a lot of other restaurants around, and I'm pretty sure their food isn't better than Moe's.
Don't worry about it, Robert. I love it here.
Thanks, Meredith. You're such a kind person.
Good evening, you two beautiful people. Ready to order?
Ladies first.
Hi, Maureen. Hard to pass up a juicy T-bone steak.
Excellent choice, Meredith. And what would you like to wash it down with?
I think I'll have a... Coke.
Gotcha. Robert?
The usual for me, Maureen.
All right, Robert. T-bone steak and a beer. Doesn't get any more lumberjack than that. Be right back, folks. Ashley, get the steaks out!
Maureen's the best. Did you hear about the open mic night she's organizing?
Yeah, she only told me about it a dozen times.
I wish I could go, especially since I heard that Jack's gonna do a thing.
Jack? What's he gonna do? Announce the weather for next week?
Believe it or not, he's a very good ballet dancer.
Yeah, right. And you're his stage manager.
No, he's into comedy. Would have loved to have heckled him. Oh well, this is a good week anyhow.
Must be nice that the apartments are off your mind for a while.
Alrighty, here are your beverages, folks. I'm afraid the food might take a little longer, as a certain kitchen helper thought the freezer was a good place for storing steaks. I really should get one of those microwave ovens to defrost them.
You seem a little stressed. Is it the upcoming open mic?
Why should I be stressed about that? It's going to be lovely. And you better be there, Robert Harris.
Maureen, I'm sorry, but I'm afraid I won't be able to make it.
I did not just hear you say that, young man. Oh, by the way, Meredith, I need to steal him for 2 minutes. He needs to check on some wiring for me.
Excuse me, Meredith. This is Maureen's jurisdiction. Have to obey the law. That tasted so good. Thanks, Maureen, for the fantastic blueberry pie.
You're welcome. It's my way of making up for stealing you away from Meredith. Ooh, I swear. She can give quite the stink eye if she wants, can't you, hon?
Ooh, boy. The world would be boring without her. Speaking of, are you gonna miss your daily delivery round?
Yes, I probably will.
Must be nice here, compared to the big city.
Do you think you'll always live here?
Nothing's for sure, but I like it here. I needed to change towns after my divorce. Everything and everyone reminded me of her.
And how are you now? Have you gotten over it?
But maybe I shouldn't bother you with the innermost feelings of a lumberjack.
Maybe not. I mean, if you don't want to.
Robert and Meredith, sorry to break up your conversation, but we're closing up early tonight. Gotta set up some stuff for the open mic night, and I can't use any peeping eyes.
Oh, okay, Maureen. No problem.
Let me get the check for you, so I can leave you two to your lovely evening.
Can you put it on my tab, Maureen?
Anything for you, darling.
Thanks, Robert.
Don't mention it. You've helped me out so much. This is nothing compared to that. Now let's get going before Maureen gets her broom out. Meredith, thanks again for your help. I'm not sure what would have happened if you hadn't come here for your mail delivery vacation.
You're welcome, Robert. I was happy to help you out.
A little help goes a long way. Hope to see you around again.
You too, Robert. Take care. Good luck with the apartments, and call me if you need help.
Anyway, I love this town. You know I do. So, I'm dedicating my last jokes to specific people here tonight. The first one's for Maureen. A guy walks into a bar, and dozens of slabs of meat are hanging from the ceiling. So he asks the bartender, "What's up with the hanging meat up there, man?" So the bartender says, "Ah, you're new here. Well, we like to play a game here. If you can jump up and slap a stake, the house will pay for your drinks all night. However, if you miss, you have to pay everyone else's bar tab. So, want to give it a go? Nah, says the man. Those stakes are too high. This one's for our own newcomer, Meredith Weiss. So, a woman's driving down the freeway, but all of a sudden, she hears a local news bulletin warning drivers on the very freeway she's on. They're saying, please be advised of this very dangerous situation of a car going the wrong way. So the woman says to herself, one car? Why, there's dozens!
Well, folks, wasn't that special? Now, let me know if any of you have any jokes about Jack, you hear? It's an open mic, after all. It's actually time for a little break right now. So come on up to the bar for some of our finest concessions. We'll continue shortly.
Mildred, how are you? And how are the cats?
Fine on both counts, dear. Thank you for asking. So, do you like the hair?
Looking fine as always.
Thank you, dear. Pity it's quite the waste of time and money, seeing as how I can't stay for long.
Really? What's the rush?
You see, my son decided to drop by, unannounced, and he's staying the whole weekend.
Oh, that's wonderful news.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, anyway, take care, dear. Now, where did he park the car?
Yes, it's me, Matt Kearney, in an egg brace. Real funny, huh?
Oh, hi, Matt. What happened?
Well, I was about to send the final boss to the afterlife, but then the computer crashed. I kicked my foot out in anger and fell from my chair, and now I'm here looking like a loser.
I'm sure you'll beat the game one day. Don't give up on the dream.
I can't play like this, but I'm going to work out a strategy in the meantime.
Guess who?
Basil from Baker Street.
Aw, now I'm going to be a disappointment. It's just me.
Even better, though I never would have guessed.
So, what have I missed?
Not much. Jack just did some comedy. But the final act is supposed to be the real showstopper. At least, that's what Maureen tells me.
Really? Well then, I guess I arrived just in time.
So, how have you been? Thanks for the note. It was very sweet.
I meant every word, babe. So, have you...
Hey, Angie. Hey, Meredith. Sorry to pop in like this, but I just wanted to inform you I fixed everything on the RV. She's got a new radio, I replaced some wiring, adjusted windshield wiper speed. The Hermit Shell is ready to go!
That's great, Lori. Thanks. I'm sure it's like she's brand new.
Well, I wouldn't say that, but you'll see. Gotta go, later!
An RV, huh?
Oh, it's kind of a long story. You know Mickey and June?
The hiker couple, right?
Well, long story short, I've somehow gained possession of their vehicle of choice, which, as Miss Young just described, is a perfectly adequate RV that I'm gonna use to motor right out of this sad little town.
So you're definitely leaving?
Absolutely. Come with me. I mean it. Leave this sad old town behind and go wherever we want to go. Free spirits, the way Mickey and June intended.
I have grown quite fond of you, you know.
Likewise, Miss Weiss. But at some point, you've got to give me a definite answer. You get that, right?
Look alive, folks. It's time for the final act. It's a doozy.
Saved by the bell, babe. I got stuff to do anyway.
Angie, wait.
Dear people, none other than our own Kay Evans will perform next. She has been writing songs since she was a little girl, and I cannot say how thrilled I am to host her first performance of hopefully many to come. I am so proud of you, honey. Please put your hands together for Kay, everyone. This does not happen a lot, but you have left me speechless. That was Kay, people. Another round of applause.
Well, it's a good thing I didn't leave when Reynolds started his nonsense. This kid can sing.
Oh, hi, Mr. Mackey. Yeah, she's awesome.
Yeah, it's good to see someone flourish, but I'd rather be home right now.
Isn't it fun to step out every once in a while?
Smoking a pipe and reading a proper book is the only acceptable way to spend a Sunday evening in September.
Bert, thank you so much for coming. I know you'd rather be somewhere else right now.
That's okay, kid. I don't regret it one bit. You did great. But ladies, if you'll excuse me, I'm out of here.
Good night, Bert. Thanks again.
And now for an announcement. I'm serious, so hush now. Now, you all know that Kay has been working here at the diner for quite a while now. In fact, she was my anchor after Stan left us. And I think the time has come to formally announce right here that I will put your name above the door of this place, honey, where it belongs. Kay's place. Mo Kay's. We haven't settled on a name yet, but there you go. Another round of applause. And have some drinks with us.
That was amazing.
Oh my gosh, thank you so much, Em. It felt amazing. I was so super nervous, you know? Like, shaking and all that. I'm so glad it went well.
Kay's place, huh? Congratulations! That was quite a surprise.
Yeah, I told you. Mo asked me, like, a gazillion times, right? Kind of felt right this time. We haven't hashed out any details, as you might have noticed. But it feels good, you know?
How did it feel to be up there?
Oh, it was so great to be performing again. It felt amazing. I'm all over the place right now. It was such a rush. I will definitely be doing that again. If they let me, of course.
That's great. I am so proud of you, Kay. You really have made a great life here.
Thanks, Em. I'd like to think so. Big day tomorrow, right? You know what you're going to do?
Honestly? Well,
wait, I'm not good at this stuff, so I just want to say was good to have you back these past weeks, Em. Really good. You just do what you feel you have to do. I'm just glad we reconnected. Promise you'll keep in touch, whatever the outcome, yeah?
Of course.
And remember, time marches on.
See you, Kay. Thanks. For everything.
My lovely people, the time has come for the open mic part of the evening to end. Ashley was going to do a ventriloquist bit next, but I just heard he hurt his hand back in his cabin. Let me thank you again for joining us, and there's plenty of food and drink to go around.
I sure do hope they're keeping things proper in there while I'm taking a breather. So, you had fun?
Oh, it was great. Kay was amazing.
You said it. Oh, that girl is so talented. Oh, I'd give my big toe to be able to do what she does behind a keyboard. Oh, sheesh.
I'm still thinking about your news about handing over the diner. Kay's place, huh? That was quite the bombshell.
That's my style. I've mentioned it to Kay, yes, many times since Stan died. She probably thought I was joking half the time, honestly. I just want to give her the option. It's hers whenever she wants it. And if she doesn't, that's fine too.
Seems like a bold choice to announce it to the town like that, though.
Ha! You know me, hon. At least all the options are out in the open now, right?
So what's next for you, now that you're handing over the reins?
Well, to be honest, I'll probably stick around the diner for now, help out, and maybe I'll try my hand at something different on the side, you know? Maybe fix up some of those cabins in the woods. Rent them out. Never too old to find something new to do.
That sounds like a great idea.
Doesn't it just? How did things end up with Kay? You could tell me to mind my own, of course. It's just that girl is like a daughter to me.
We talked, yeah. We really reconnected, and I'm happy we did.
Listen, you're two grown women, and if that's the choice you two ended up on, I can only respect that. Speaking of choices, you've got a big day in the morning, don't you? Know what you're gonna do yet? Stick around? Move back?
I think I have a feeling. Yeah.
Then you go follow that feeling, hon.
Thanks, Maureen.
I best get back inside. You take care now, Meredith Wise.
Take care, Maureen.
Good morning, Meredith. You won't believe the weekend I had. Saturday, I placed a bet on the White Sox, just like you said, and lost. But they played again yesterday, and I let it ride. And then they won. They're playing again tonight, and now I don't know what to do anymore.
Well, Frank, the pattern is obvious. And betting against the pattern pays off, White Sox.
Okay, Meredith, thanks. I'll go with that. Speaking of gambling, I bet you're taking the job. And that's not just because you're wearing your coat.
I love the coat, Frank. But no, I'm taking it off. I'm leaving Providence Oaks again.
Aw, that's not what I was hoping to hear, Meredith. But I understand. What are you going to do?
Well, actually, I'm...
A van? So you're staying in the delivery business? No, wait. That's an RV.
Yep. I'm getting on it, and I'm not sure where I'll stop. So, I guess this is goodbye. I'm gonna miss you, Frank. Thanks for everything. Try to stay out of trouble, okay?
Don't worry, Meredith. I'll be fine. Thanks for everything. Take care and drive safe.
And the V-belt is not in great shape, but it should last you another month or three. The Hermit Shell in all of her glory. Do you like her? Meredith and I named her.
She's pretty amazing, Lori. Cute name, too. Thanks for doing this for me.
You're very welcome.
I thought you really wanted to have the RV, Lori.
I wanted to work on her really badly. But now that she doesn't need any more work, Angie can at least drive her around. Since I don't have a license, and I'm not old enough to get one anyway.
I'll keep you up to date on all our adventures, promise. It'll be like you're right there with us.
I'm counting on it. Hey, Meredith, I'm going to miss you.
I'll miss you too, Lori. It was really fun watching that movie and working on the RV with you.
Me too. Besides, you'll be back sometime, right?
Of course. I have to check on my favorite engineer.
You mean me? Ha! I'd love that. Safe travels, Meredith.
Thank you, Lori. See you around.
Magnificent, isn't she?
Yeah, she certainly knows a lot about cars for a kid her age.
I meant the RV. But sure, Lori's great too.
So, you all packed?
Sure am. The big stuff's in storage. But I've got the bare necessities. Clothes, toiletries, and a whole bunch of videotapes. So, where are we going first?
Yeah, about that.
Hmm?
I have one condition. I get to pick which movie we watch first.
Deal. I'm in the driver's seat, by the way. I've heard about your driving.
What have you heard? From who?
People talk.
When advertising exec David Howard, parentheses Albert Brooks, is passed over for a promotion and subsequently fired, he decides to change his whole life. He convinces his wife Linda, parentheses Monica Johnson, to sell their house and roam the country, easy rider style, in a Winnebago. Okay, forget this one. That's just not going to be relatable at all.
Nope. We've got nothing in common with those guys. I have another flick where a bunch of academics set up a ghost hunting business in an old fire station. That should be way more accessible.
Angie Eastman, have you seen every single tape in here?
Not all of them, but most.
Come on!
But I don't mind watching them again. In fact, I'd love to see them with someone who...
knows nothing about movies?
I was going to put it a little nicer than that. Someone who has unspoiled virgin eyes.
Virgin eyes? What are you, a poet now? All right, well... Lost in America will unspool before these virgin eyes soon enough. Tell me about Stand By Me. It's about four kids from Oregon, right?
Sorry for butting in, folks, but I've got a special treat for y'all. I just updated my playlist. This new song is from our very own Kay Evans.